Don't know, my people. Oh, go on, you get me? This one here is on a serious note now, yeah? To the man them out here, yeah? And to the young G's out here, yeah? And anyone in general, listen, this is about business for the man them, yeah? This is what I'm saying, like, I'm hearing on the net now, man can't read and write, so man ain't reading contracts, man are getting bumped over contracts, cause man can't read and write, and this bullshit like that. Hear what, brothers and sisters? You see, man can't look down on any situation if a man can't read and write, you know, or a sister can't read and write. We don't know the means why he or she can't do that. Do you understand what I'm saying? But what I will say on this thing, yeah, is you got man now that want fight. You got man that want prize fight. You got man that want fucking rap. You got man that want to do all sort of things in this entertainment business and in general, yeah. Even going out and raving and doing certain things. And brother, you can't read and write. Like, where the fuck is man's priorities at, eh, G? Like, man's supposed to read and write. Listen to what I'm saying to the man, them. I know people that came back from generation, you get me? That generation what came over this country, you understand what I'm saying? And even them, they broke their back to read and write. Remember, it's a shameful thing, you know, if you're in a space where you're able to do it and you can't do it, brother. Remember what I'm saying, man's got to start looking down on these things. Like, you G's ain't looking down on, you can't read and write. Like, brothers, go and read and write. Fix up your fucking priorities before you're reading contracts and signing contracts and jumping up and down here and there and everywhere. Remember, this whole thing in life is about priorities, you know? Yeah, and that's a big priority. If you can't read and write, forget the situation, forget the past, activate now and learn how to fucking read and write and stop signing contracts or doing certain things, even just going out and gallivanting and you can't read and write. Are you all right? Back in the day, they were going fucking like evening schools and them thing there. You lot can do it online and that now. You get me? There's no excuse for a man to be born in this country, got sent to school now, yeah, and you can't read and write. What the fuck's going on? Like, you see the schooling system, it ain't that bad where a man can't read and write. It's you young G's and the man them putting themselves through it certain times, yeah? And that's what I said, the stigma about reading and writing is, you get me? Let's not take it lightly. A man's got to read and write, man. A man's got to gain knowledge. I don't know what I'm to you, man. It's like you don't want to gain knowledge. Yeah, a certain period in your life when you recognize, okay, cool, I went through that and I couldn't read and write, but now is the time to gain knowledge and learn. A man want to learn winding up and down in dances. A man want to learn fucking, you understand, rapping rather than you want. How you men are going to be rappers and that? How you men are going to be rappers and you can't pick good words to use? You're only going to have a vocabulary you can stick with. You're not going to widen your horizon and broaden your horizon with your vocabulary if you can't educate yourself and you can't read and write. So all you man talk about, you want to be musicians. Check certain things as well, you know. You see certain musicians, you look at them and you can tell they had a good upbringing. They had a good, like, you get me, education system behind them. By the way they're flinging their words around and that. Don't get it twisted. Not a lot of these men are really from the sticks. Certain of them are from the sticks, but they went to a little uni or they went to a little good school and they come back in the end. Don't get this thing twisted. To be a good musician, you better be able to play with words. You understand? And pick good words to use. You can't just be using the same vocabulary. You understand what I'm saying? It's a man gets to know anyway, yeah? If you can't read and write, brothers and sisters, go and look about that now. That should be your first priority. New Year's resolution. I need to know how to read and write. There's one thing, you know, that I've clocked with this younger generation. You see, they're too easy to hold grudges and that, yeah? They run off emotions a lot. That makes them hold their grudges and want to just do stupidness. They react off emotion. How come you see so much violence going on out there? There's no real men standing up and talking to them and making them handle their emotions like a man. Listen, let me tell you like something. There's no way, yeah, I move off of like emotions and my heart. I move off my brain. Do you understand what I'm saying? It's a mental thing. That's how you move. You don't make nothing get you to the extent where it's going to draw you out and make you do a stupidness before you've assessed it. Do you understand what I'm saying? Like, you've got to assess that situation and think, you know what? I want to do this now. Yeah, but I'm telling the man and that these young G's, stop running off emotions. Stop being quick to cut people. Stop being quick to shoot people. Because when you think about it, it's just an emotional tap at one moment. And then after that, you're fucked for the rest of your life. Remember that, yeah? Sit down and think about certain things before you activate, brothers. Yeah, and that just goes within life in general. Anything you do, assess it. A real man will sit down and assess the situation. He ain't just going to jump into no situation. I told man, a lot of women, yeah, are getting beat up by emotional men. A real man ain't gonna beat no woman. Stop being emotional, brothers. Yeah, walk away. I told man them already. An emotional man is just a detriment to himself. And we got to look at another thing. Any man that wants, yeah, man them to know what you've done on the road, yeah, you're a dangerous nigga. You're dangerous to you and everyone around you. Man them remember that. Yeah, any nigga that wants his thing to be sound out on the rooftops, he's a dangerous nigga to himself. You got to watch that. I said as well, I'm not bigging up no rascal like musician, but there was a musician that spoke on that 12-year-old girl, yeah, when she got put down and that, yeah. And a mad thing up there, you get me stabbed up or what, yeah. But I'll big up that artist there for speaking about it. We need more of them artists there talking about these things and bringing awareness to the thing. You see how one artist just spoke about it and it started going mad all around the place. Imagine if 12, 50 artists done that now, yeah. The sort of outrage and I gotta say one thing, big up them people up there as well, yeah, for gathering and coming out in the community, showing what it should be. When any little child dies on any community, that's how the community should be there. Get me to comfort the family. See, the next thing now where we got a problem as well, yeah. We got most of these women now, yeah, with certain men. See, these simp man, yeah. We got most of these women laughing at man rather than respecting man. Yeah, Carl, all of these simps, they're not getting respected. They're getting laughed at by their woman. You understand? Because I've been looking on this now. I don't know if the people them know where I'm going, but I seem to be looking on a gram thing certain time, yeah. And I'm seeing one newt just dancing up like one bitch, shaking his legs like one bitch. And it's like these men seem to think it's comedy, yeah. But I tell you what, the gal in looking at you like comedy. You're a joke, man, fam. To be dancing and whining up in front of yourself, in front of camera, yeah. Big man, you're on a joke thing. Like, I don't know what's going on. No wonder why. No wonder why the gal them ain't got no respect for certain men on the roads now. Because I'm looking at it and sisters, don't ever get this thing twisted and mix up us man with them man there, you know. Never don't listen, yeah, different kettle of fish. We could never be one of them man there, yeah. But I'm looking at this jackass whining up himself in front of the camera thinking it's good. You trying to impress women, bro, like that. Is that what you man are on now? Impressing women by whining up yourself and dancing like a bitch on screen, yeah. Told you anyway, as I said, sisters, the real sisters, all up your head and that real alpha males, you don't know what time it is. You never catch us doing that. I'm like that in a million. You understand what time it is, but yeah, it makes me laugh, but then I want to cry when I look at it. Cause I just think this is what men have become to today. When you look at it, these are the men, and these are the men that's in positions and teaching our youths in positions where our youths are looking up to, like watching things and getting mad views, and this is what our kids are looking at. That's supposed to be the men of today. You lot are the men of today. You lot ain't no men of today, fam. Like, I'm telling you straight up and down. So all I'm saying is stop showing our kids these sort of things. We don't want to see big grown man winding up themselves in front of cameras, bro. Bro, find another way to make some money, man.